Show me that smile.
Ooh, show me that smile.
Don't waste another minute on your crying. We're nowhere near.
Just admit it. you're doing is theater.
It's not theater, sir, okay? What we're doing tonight is, I guess if you put it in technical terms, it's more of a series of rehearsed scenes regarded as a dramatic work of art.
That is the dictionary definition of theater. You're doing theater. Listen, smart guy, if this was theater, then why does our show feature a song sung by our pal Nathan Lane? Are you guys even listening to what you're saying right now? No.
I'll go load the guns.
Exactly. Fucking wait, man! Jesus!
I'm sorry, I take it back. I shouldn't say anything. This is a lot like television.
Oh, do you mean it?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a lot like television in that it rots your brains!
hey, that's not cool. Me and my friends worked really hard on this show.
Yeah, I guess we're just a ragtag group of guys who had the same dream. We all dreamt of being on television. I guess things didn't really work out the way we planned it because we weren't attractive enough. That's when we realized we could still be on television if we did it on a stage. And without cameras. And with a smaller audience for less money. For no money. So yeah, that's how much we love television.
Living room. room to this caveman. Say up! Have you seen my gavel anywhere?
Ugh, make fire.
Ugh? That's not firewood, that's my gavel.
Whoops. Maybe take 15-minute recess.
Overruled.
The transition was a success. The show was even more popular than it ever had been. Unfortunately, during mid-season of the sixth season, tragedy struck when actor Kenny Kolchak suffered a major heart attack and died. But the show must go on. The writers were able to use old dialogue from previous episodes to breathe new life into the Judge Murphy character. Take a look.
I can't believe my soul strapped in this laptop after having it poured in 5 minutes! That's a great idea, Ugg! You can carry me to the courtroom!
Oh!
I said courtroom, not lunchroom! I'm not a sandwich!
Oops, 15?
Overruled.
This iteration was even more popular than the previous. Unfortunately, the following season... Unfortunately, the following season, the Actors Union went on strike, forcing Sir Victor Francis Gauthier, the actor who portrayed the caveman, unable to film any new episodes. Instead of waiting for the strike to end, the writers came up with a creative solution. Take a look.
I can't believe a witch cast the spell on Ugg the caveman and put his soul into this broom!
Overruled!
The adventures of a judge whose soul is trapped in a computer and a caveman who switched bodies with a broom shot the show into the rating stratosphere. The broom was so popular, in fact, that he got his own spinoff where he solves crimes at night. Take a look.
Well, Detective Broom, that sure is one way to clean up the streets.
Broom PI was a hit. So much so that the Broom decided not to return to Murphy's Law the following season. And without Broom, the writers were left with an uneasy and uncompromising dilemma. Here's what they did. Take a look.
I can't believe my soul is now trapped in this cup of coffee. Hey, I need a refill.
The show was canceled immediately. See, the audiences just didn't like seeing their favorite judge trapped in a cup of coffee. And that wasn't the end of Judge Murphy. The USA Network picked up the show, changing it from a wacky sitcom into a behind-the-scenes show. And the show was called Behind the Screen. This show that you're watching right now. Isn't that right, Judge Murphy?
Overruled.
Having trouble taking pills?
Yes.
Tired of drinking boring water with your pills?
Yeah, how did you know?
Do you simply have too many pills to take?
That's literally what's happening right now.
Introducing the Pill Burger. From the makers of Super Salad Spinner Speakers and the Masturbation Sock comes an exciting new way to take pills. Now, your coarse, tasteless pills will be covered in cooked beef, fresh lettuce, and tomato. Designed by German engineers to deliver up to 25 pills.
Every night before dinner, I have to take Prilosec for my heartburn. It gets kind of annoying. But now, I just crudely shove the pills in my pill burger, and then I go out and have a nice burger dinner with my family. Yeah, it's a lot of burgers, but I like it.
Pillburger makes taking pills fun for everyone.
I don't even need to take pills, but since I can take them with a burger, why not?
Order your Pillburger today. Ships in 8 to 15 days. The makers of Pillburger do not guarantee freshness and do not recommend eating spoiled meat.
Coach Thorpe is the best in the biz, and I imagine right now he's pumping his team up.
Let's hope so.
I know that it looks bad out there, boys. You're probably thinking that it's over because we're losing 100-2. By the way, Jimbo, great job. It's the ugliest goddamn pass I ever saw. It bounced off of Monroe's head and into the basket, so I'll take it.
What if I told you starting now things turn around?
What if I told you we're not going to lose this game?
Because we're not going to finish this game.
That's right. We're going to sneak out of here that we don't finish the game.
And after the game, NBC invites you all to join us for the series premiere of Dog Cop. He's half dog, half man, but the man half is a cop. Will his dog half ruin tonight's investigation by sniffing everyone's butts? Find out tonight on Dog Cop. Now, Nick, when you are down by this large a deficit, you've got to hope that Coach Thorpe is really trying to pump up his team right now.
You know, these are the moments where a coach can really inspire his team.
That's right.
You're Panthers. Remember that. So hold your head high. Unless you need to duck underneath something while you're slinking away. I want you to go out on that court and then go past that court. Cross Main Street, hang a left at the Taco Bell, then you will be outside of the city limits and too far away for someone to make you play.
And after Dog Cop, stay tuned for the exciting adventures of Top Chef Nights. Things get hot in the kitchen when contestants compete and have sex in the kitchen. Top Chef Nights tonight at 9:30.
You know, Steve, speaking of chefs, it looks like the coach is cooking up some of his famous trick plays right about now.
Mmm, tasty.
Okay, these are the opponents, right?
We need to go literally anywhere else.
You should not be my guy. That's the main idea.
After Top Chef Night, stay tuned for the series finale of Doggy Daddy Disco Judge. After 9 long seasons, Judd Adler is finally ready to leave the bench and pursue his disco dancing dreams. But can he balance dancing and being a dad? Also, he's at dog.
Boy, I wonder if my dog's a judge. I'll tell you what, if I was the coach, I'd be breaking out my best impression of Gene Hackman from Hoosiers.
Forget about the crowd, the size of the school, fancy uniforms, or how your own parents are viciously booing you. All you need to focus on is putting on these wigs and applying enough makeup so you look like a passable woman.
Make sure to check out the mid-season replacement of Murphy's Law. It's the story of a man who is already half dog and then runs into a gypsy who curses the other half of him, making him one whole dog. Today, I'm Dog Dog.
You're beautiful women! You're beautiful women! Let's go! Let's go!
Yeah.
You're taking an intermission. fuck that is. What we're doing is a TV live break. You see, we're real TV nuts, as you can see, and we like to know what our audience is watching, you know? As a matter of fact, why don't we start with this guy?
Yeah, what's your favorite show of all time?
Favorite show of all time, yeah, I guess, Seinfeld.
Huh?
Seinfeld.
Steinfeld?
Steinfeld.
Is that like a cop? It's like a cop show?
Maybe like an American show.
Yeah, maybe a show that's not so obscure so everybody else can get it.
Alright, friends.
Yeah, we're all friends.
Yeah,
friends.
Yeah. Like to tell you.
Okay.
Dad, I'm gay.
I accept you for who you are because you're my son, and I have to go to the bathroom. Yeah, I know, you're gay, I accept it. Gotta go to the bathroom, excuse
me. No, I just crashed the Jeep, Dad!
Ashes to ashes, dust to dust. Today we mourn our beloved Tina.
Oh, Tina! You died before I ever got a chance to tell you just how much I have to go to the bathroom.
Here we mourn the loss of our beloved Francine, mother and wife.
Oh, Francine, you died before I ever got a chance to tell you just how much I had to go to the bathroom. Excuse me.
Hey, what am I doing? I don't have to run around anymore. I'm free. I'm finally free. You know, it's funny. All these years of running around, I never actually got to use the bathroom.
Oh, my bladder!
Wishes they were more beautiful, but when it comes to plastic surgery, it's hard to know where to start. The mouth? The eyes? The nose? Who can tell? Well, we've taken the guesswork out of plastic surgery and boiled it down to one face. This face. It's the perfect face. We do one face and one face only, and it's this face. Now, let's talk to some satisfied customers.
Before meeting Dr. Bobby, I look like this. But now, with the face, I look like this. Thanks, Dr. Bobby. I used to look like this. But being a hot babe isn't all it's cracked up to be. Sometimes you just want to live life, pay for a drink, have a bushy beard and a smelly asshole. Bark, 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 bark. Woof. Bark, 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 bark. Bark, 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 bark. Bark. Meow.
Hey, Mom. You're never going to believe it. I got the face.
It's going to take a little while for the eyes to really set in there.
Get the face today. Hey, it worked for me.
Creole mac and cheese.
Steve, it was an excellent dish.
Unfortunately, your mac and cheese was a little bit too spicy for me. Because your beans were a little spicy as well. But all in all, good job, Steve.
Oh, thank you, Chef.
Could you maybe now describe a little bit of the sex you had last night?
It was great. It was fantastic.
All right. Could you maybe elaborate a little bit?
Oh, sure, yeah. Well, we got drunk off the vodka the crew provides, so thank you for that. And then, you know, we talked a little bit, you know, I guess I reminded her of her dad a little bit because I wear jeans. You know, one thing led to another and we really boned it on home.
Wonderful positions.
Oh boy, well, it's kind of hard to remember with all the vodka. But let's see, I know we definitely started in missionary. And then I remember like flipping over to cowgirl, and then there was like a weird suction sound, but then we just kind of slowed it down. Suction sound totally went away.
Excellent work, Steve.
Thanks, Chef.
Nick, you're up next.
Okay. I also decided to braise my oxtail. I'm sorry. Why did you ask him about sex?
Because this is Top Chef Matt. It's sort of what we do. We talk about food for a little bit or whatever, and then we move on to the sultry sex stuff.
Oh, all right.
You did have sex last night, did you not?
Don't you want me to describe my dish, or?
Chef, I'm pretty sure this guy was jerking into Big Bang last night. Bazinga!
Unfortunately, Nick, if you did not have sex last night, you will be disqualified, and Steve will be our winner.
No need for that, Chef. No need for that, because I definitely boofed last night. I definitely had sex last night.
Bullshit.
With whom did you boof?
I'm pretty sure he boofed Freddy Five Fingers. Was it?
Hey, fuck you, man.
I would never.
I had sex with somebody that's not in the competition. As a matter of fact, I'm pretty sure she's from Canada, so it's all great. But I definitely boofed.
That would be Nico. We have a saying here at Top Chef, Nat's a boof is a boof.
All right. Okay. All good then. All good.
Well, I do not believe that you had sex.
Wait, what?
But if you could maybe describe it a little bit.
Oh, yeah, yeah, no. Oh, yeah, no, yeah. No fucking way. Yeah, I did that. Okay, cool. Oh, you want to hear about it? Oh, dude, you want to fucking hear about it? Oh, my God. Get ready for this one. It's going to be nuts.
Nick, it's okay if you did not boo.
No, I booed, man. Shut the fuck up for a second. Let me fucking talk. Okay, you want to hear a story, dude? You fucking strap in, dude, and I'm talking about your dicks, man. Okay, Lord knows I did. Afterwards. Alright, okay, set the scene. Okay, first of all, there was a chick there, pretty sure. And, man, there was fucking, okay, here we go. We had two tits on this side, four if you count mine. And then we had two assholes on this side, four if you count mine. And, what else, dude? Oh, dude, I fucking got in there, man. I picked it up. At one point, man, we were both on top. It was nuts! I just rode that wave, though, man. It was so sweaty and hairy. Also, man, we had sex. We fucking had sex. We fucked. And then, oh man, then I had her sign a release. That doesn't sound right. Then there were fucking two guys that took pictures of the Empire State Building and made postcards out of them. That's a different story. Alright, so, oh, I used my dick. And then, fucking two, alright, here we go. It was like I was in a street fight with Clint Eastwood and a monkey, man. It was every which way but loose, and I did a triple Indian in that canal, but you better believe, I had a snorkel. And also, some clam diggers, because I was in the ocean. Also, I got one for you. I'm a virgin. I'm a virgin.
next.
Well, there was that one time Steve got stuck in the elevator with a pregnant woman and had to deliver her baby.
That's true. That was a crazy day. Lost a good watch that day.
You also lost your wallet, and I'd like you to look inside.
My watch! Right. You're good, man.
I'm very good. Man, I can't believe that's it. It's really over, man.
Yeah. No more humorous misunderstandings.
No more wacky adventures.
No more humorous misunderstandings.
Or am I?
Wait a second.
Theater guy?
Actually.
Hollywood guy?
The name's Blaze Hendo. Hollywood. I'm sorry, he needs to see. Boys, I've been watching your show. I've been watching it real close. And let me tell you this, I love it.
Oh, man, you love TV Live?
I love TV Live.
Oh, awesome.
It's great. And you know what? Back in Hollywood land, me and a few other Hollywood guys are making some programs for stupid fucking idiots with terrible tastes and everything. And we think that you idiots can make the perfect programming for those stupid idiots. What do you say?
I just resigned, Elise. Mr. Hendo?
Please, take your time.
Mr. Hendo, while we appreciate the offer, that's not really what this show is all about.
Oh.
You see, we were never chasing the glitz and glamour of Hollywood. We were just three ragtag guys who wanted to put on a fun show for the people. And I guess if that means giving up all the Hollywood
cash. I'll do it!
What?
Great.
I
need you to sign here.
Wait a minute. Holy shit, you can fucking do that, man? No. Take me too! I fucking hate Steve! Well, that's fine, because I fucking love Steve.
So, buddy, welcome to Hollywood. Here are your official Hollywood shades. And here's your official stack of Hollywood Jew money.
Whoa!
You can't forget your Hollywood Jew cocaine.
Hey, Zach? Don't forget about your old pal, Steve, all right?
Of course I won't, couch.
Steve, couch.
Hey, hot shot, we leave your what?
Yeah, all right.
Hey, it looks like our TV Live guide is open to a page that says that Zach's show is on right now.
Oh, wow. Let's watch it.
Yeah.
Honey, I cleaned the garage. Now can we have the sex?
Oh, you did you? Even the crawl space?
Oh, brother, I forgot about the crawl space.
Well, then you can forget about crawling in this space.
Oh, I hate my life.
Stage.
Whoa, it's kind of like theater, right?
Nothing like theater. and glamour doesn't really amount to much without friends.
No, it just turns out I'm a really bad actor. Plus, the Hollywood guy tried to fuck me.
Hey,
I'm sorry about everything, Patch.
Well, I guess this whole thing was a bust then, huh?
Yeah, what do you say we just go slink on backstage?
Alright.
Lights out, you're done.
Hey, wait a minute, guys. Let's go slink back this way. What if, stay with me, this wasn't the end of TV Live?